blocks taller.
Yep. You know, you just they haven't met many teams that they haven't been outside.
Yeah, not all year. Tip comes off to St. Joe. Brinkerhoff with the tip. And it's chased down by Ray. Morton. Carrington, pass down in.
Shakespeare hit the floor.
He's tripped up.
And St. Joe's comes out in a three-quarter court trap.
Cross court to Leach. Tipped out.
See if they bring somebody to the corner. It's kind of like a 1-2-2, or to the middle. Kind of a 1-2-2 half-court trap.
Into Brinkerhoff. Drives, kicks to Easton for three.
Rebound foul on Shakespeare. See if I can see that.
Away from the ball.
Replay. Rebound foul.
Elizabeth made it back. She's on that camera down there. She... Cut back door by Ray. Won't go. Tipped up by White. And in. White is so good coming backside the play. Bounce pass ahead to Brinkerhoff. Brinkerhoff goes. Kicks it to Shakespeare. Off the glass for two. Assist Brinkerhoff, bucket Shakespeare. White's fouled.
So look at that replay, Mike, and Shakespeare boxing out after the shot. I don't have it on there anymore. So I don't know if it's because it was a dead ball, he kept boxing out.
Right.
I think that's why they blew the whistle.
Mason White makes his first and second. Foul goes to Easton Syrett. Two quick fouls on the Mustangs. To Tate Leach, drives, kicks it to Trey Tibbs. Austin will take the three. Rims off, rebound, Morton. Trey's fingers out of bounds. Tried to go before he caught the ball.
Tell him, Tebbs, to take it in. You got to go up with it.
Trey can't attack. White. Morton. Ball loose. Taken away by Leach. Syrett and blocking foul on Kerrigan. Easton's line misses his first. Gavin Henderson Anderson into the game, number 31. Misses both. Ahead to Ray. Morton, the White, fakes, drives, kicks it up. Morton. Lob down in over the top.
Can't quite get the ball out of the railing.
Brinkerhoff drives, steps around White, shot up, won't go. Brinkerhoff, and the foul. Pass into Austin Brinkerhoff. Tate Leach for three. Off the back iron. Rebound White. Mason White gives back to Morton. Anderson. Lob into Don Levy. Morton drives, scoops, and scores. 6-2. Don Levy takes the pass away. Brinkerhoff takes it back. And Don Levy with the foul. St. Joe Jayhawks too fast, Dave, for the Mustangs to make slow lob passes. They've got to be crisp and sharp.
Definitely.
Brinkerhoff gets the corner on White. And one.
You know, when White comes guarding Brinkerhoff, kind of bellies up there. But Austin Brinkerhoff, small enough, stays low enough that he can get around that corner and get to the basket.
Free throw rims out. 0-3 from the line for the Mustangs. 6-4, Jayhawks. 3-point shot by Ray. Banks. Rebound out to Morton for three. That one won't go. Leach with the rebound for the Mustangs. Leach, little floater. Gets his own rebound out to Austin Brinkerhoff for three. That won't go. White with the rebound. White picks up his dribble. Bounce pass into Don Levy. Anderson, shot off. Rebound Brinkerhoff. Syrett Brinkerhoff. Leach drives left. Hands to Easton. Easton fakes, drives. And a blocking foul.
The line shooting two.
That's one of those 50-50 calls, Dave. You're just never sure. Easton misses another free throw. Mustangs 0-for-4 from the foul line. Got that one. Anderson turns, looks. Don Levy.
Game the
Ray. White cuts. Leach takes the ball away. Mustang's doing a good job taking that cut away. Yesterday, White had that every time he wanted it. Leach sets, shoots three off the iron. Rebound White.
Mustang struggled a little from that three-point line today, Mike.
0-5 so far.
You know, you're into day two of the tournament. Really day three with a playoff game.
Couple playoff games, or a playoff game for the Mustangs. Ray for three. That's good. 9-5, St. Joe. Pass taken away. Morton on the break. Tipped by Brinkerhoff. And blocked. Brinkerhoff gets the corner, scoops it up, and one. Austin Brinkerhoff basket is good. Foul zone again. Anderson's second. Max Alstrom and TJ Brinkerhoff in for the Mustangs. Both of them sophomores. Mustangs have three sophomores on the field, court.
On the field.
On the field, on the gridiron. Brinkerhoff makes that one. 8-9, St. Joe. White for three. Tebbs with the rebound. Timeouts. It's Coach Syrett. We'll be back after this. Alrighty, folks. Off the timeout from the Mustangs. It's Mustang basketball. Score 9-8. Jayhawks. Tebbs drives. Easton drives in the paint. Gets a lane. Takes it in for two. The Mustangs with a 1-point lead. White. Morton cuts and is fouled. Austin Brinker off the foul. His first. Jayhawks perfect from the line, 3 of 3. Rims out. Austin Brinkerhoff with the rebound. Tie ball game at 10s. Brinkerhoff will take the three. Rebound White. Morton pulls up. 10-footer. Won't go. Gets his own rebound. Bounce pass across and fouled.
Foul going against Max Alstrom. Shooting two.
Anderson makes it. 11-10. Makes them both. Austin spins back into the middle. Ball out to Leach. Leach drives. Scoops. Misses. Rebound. TJ Brinkerhoff kicks it out to Austin. Austin penetrates. Dishes to Alstrom. Puts it up. And in. Beautiful look from Brinkerhoff and a nice basket by Alstrom. White. Ray for three. He hit the last one. He shot. No good. Leach with the rebound. And a bump. That'll put Brinker off the line shooting a 1-1. Thank you. Drayton Tibbs back in the game. Easton will catch a breather for 15 seconds, and then I'll bet they have him back in the game for the second quarter. Misses. Leach with the rebound. Gives to Brinkerhoff. Brinkerhoff scoops it up. Alstrom with the rebound and got it.
Nice rebound by Alstrom at the buzzer. And we'll be right back.
The Alton Coal Development is located in Alton, Utah. The development employs 32 people at the extraction site and another 30 are employed driving trucks. Alton Coal reclaims the land by restoring habitat for sage grouse and cattle. Alton Coal, restoring habitat and creating jobs.
Bryce Canyon City is your gateway to Bryce Canyon National Park. We have hotels, restaurants, world-class shopping, parks, and a full range of Western activities. Bryce Canyon City, the place to be. The Bryce Canyon Pines, home to Ethel's world-famous homemade pie, would like to wish all of the Garfield County teams good luck. We would like to thank our loyal local customers for supporting our business for the past 60 years. Bryce Canyon Inn is conveniently located in the heart of Bryce Canyon. Enjoy a complimentary hot breakfast. For dinner, enjoy our world-famous pizza or McLean's favorite, the Sidewinder. The owners, Tyson, Casey, McLean, and Mary Lee, wish the Mustangs success.
Ready, here we go.
Missed a basket.
We're back.
You missed one?
Did Dawson have two, or does he have one? Austin had two baskets, I think.
Yeah.
Second quarter. Mustangs lead by three. Trey Tibbs with the take. Baseline shot up over the top. Rebound, Gavin Anderson.
Good drive there. He had the screen in front of him. Foul on Syrett.
That's his second foul, I believe. Maybe it's his first. White in the corner. Pulls up, rims off. Brinkerhoff with the rebound. Leach, Brinkerhoff in the corner, will take the three. Rims off, right side. White with the rebound. Morton. Anderson. Ray for three. Peyton Leach with a big rebound. Trade. Tate with the ball taken from Tate. Morton scoops, gets it. Tate to Easton. Drives, kicks. Trey Tibbs will step, drive, shot over White for two. Nice take by Tibbs. Don Levy, Morton. Morton for deep two. And the foul on Morton will put Leach at the line. St. Joe. Tate makes his first. Second as well. Tate's first points of the game. 19-16 Bryce Valley.
Leach called with a foul. He almost had that, but he got a little bit of arm.
Tate's first foul. White was wide open. Both defenders went with Morton to the corner. Morton loses the handle, spins back around, picks it back up. Ray. Deep three for Morton.
Dang. That one was out there.
10 Ray's. Points in the game for Morton. Averages 19 on the season. Trey Tebbs will take a three. That one rims off. Austin Brinkerhoff with the put up and fouled. Morton averages 19 points and Mason White 17. And the Mustangs have done a good job with White. They've allowed Morton to get.
Now he's got a pretty good
10.
Morton's good shooting form. Feet straight, smooth on that three-point shot.
Brinkerhoff makes. That's a third foul on Gavin Anderson. That will bring James Kerrigan back in. Kerrigan was the starter. Austin misses that one. Austin, 3 of 6 from the foul line. Mustangs as a team, 6 of 12, 50%. Morton gets past Tabs. Ray for three. Ball loose, Ray. Austin Brinkerhoff, second foul. Danny Hoosland. .23-20 Diamond Ranch. Easton with the rebound.
St. Joe's,
not Diamond Ranch. Leach looks. Leach drives, kicks it back out to Easton. Trey. Brinkerhoff in the corner. Won't go. Rebound. Pulled down by Don Levy. Ray, Brinkerhoff with the steal and the lay-in. Brinkerhoff. And a finger looks like Hoosland. Just haven't looked at. St. Joe. Three-point basket by Morton. Mustangs are going to have to get a hand in his face. And one, Easton Syrett with a strong take and the foul on Kerrigan. Easton makes that one. Taken away again by Brinkerhoff. Lays it up. 1 point lead for the Mustangs. Three-pointer by Morton. Leach with the rebound. Back to Morton. Pulls up, down to White, and one. Fouled by Syrett. That's Syrett's third foul, Dave. And St. Joe back on top by one. 28-27. 29-27. Trey to Tate. TJ. Tate fakes, steps left, pulls up, got it. Mustang basketball.
What was the call on that one, Mike?
Just tipped out of bounds by.
Okay.
Max and Kerrigan going for the ball. Went off Kerrigan last. And a foul on Morton. That's his third personal.
Kind of evens it up a little bit with Syrett down. We'll see if they bring somebody in from Morton.
They have Jack Yang. Zhang? Zong?
How do you spell it?
Zhang. Z-H-A-N-G.
Zhang? Zhang?
Zhang in the game.
They leave Morton in.
They do, and they take out Kerrigan.
They must have extremely amount of confidence in him to not pick up that fourth foul.
Leach makes them both. White.
Missed the first one. Mike.
Missed the first one. Tipped away by Alstrom. Picked up by TJ. Out to Austin. Austin steps around. Scoops it up. No good. Jump ball. So Tate missed the first one. Rods, that you said. Morton over TJ, won't go. Two-shot foul for Morton. Yeah. 11 points in the game for Morton, or in this quarter for Morton.
Now he's got a sub coming in.
Ties it up, and then a one-point lead for the Jayhawks. TJ. Oh, nice pass from TJ down to Austin. Won't go in.
Yeah, TJ Brinkhoff just kind of snuck in behind the defense in the middle of that zone. Got to realize, folks out there, we go first names on the Mustangs. A lot of them have the same last name, at least with Brinkhoff, I guess.
Yeah, TJ and Austin.
It's really only about it, even though they're all cousins, pretty much.
Well, then there's two Brinkhoffs on the bench.
Bench, too, yeah.
Austin makes one of two.
Full timeout. Thunder a minute to go here in the
31-31. We'll be back after this.
Danny and Wendy Brinkhoff of Bryce Country Cabins, located in Tropic, Utah, invite you to come stay in a beautiful, clean, comfortable cabin with a view of the Escalante Mountain that'll take your breath away. Wishing the Mustangs success. Bryce Photo specializes in Old West photos, horse ride photos, and photo enlargement. Bring in your digital photos for Vance and Gene Pollock to print in a variety of sizes. Step back in time and get a photo of how you might have looked in the Old West. Wishing the Mustangs success. Bryce Pioneer Village, comfortable hotel rooms, historic cabins, and for a peaceful outdoor setting, we have an RV park. If you're looking for some great entertainment and dinner in one place, visit the Showdowns Restaurant at Bryce Pioneer Village. Go Mustangs!
Bryce Canyon Subway wants to thank Region 20 teams for eating with us this year. Locals get 20% off regular prices and great deals on catering. During February, all classic footlongs are only $6. We also have full and part-time jobs available. Join a great team and become a sandwich artist. Go Mustangs!
Alrighty, folks, off the timeout, it's Jayhawk basketball. Mustangs in the 2-2-1. White. Morton. To White.
Looks like they'll hold for one shot.
White. Didn't even turn and look. White could, he'd have had a 3-on-2 there. Morton drives, pulls up, rims off, rebound. Foul on Austin Brinkhoff, his third. That's a big foul for the Mustangs.
Got his arm on that rebound, yeah, swatting it out of bounds.
White, 4 of 4 from the foul line. Gets them both. At the half, 33-31, Jayhawks. You're watching Utah High School Sportscast, and we'll be back after this.
Bullseye Pest Control, specializing in bug, lawn, fruit tree, garden, and weed spraying, termite pre-treats, and free termite inspections. A beautiful lawn doesn't happen by itself. Now's the time to aerate your lawn, serving Garfield, Paiute, Sam Pete, and Wayne counties. Give Jeff a call, 435-313-2855.
Experience on the back of a horse or sure-footed mule. You see the spectacular scenery of Bryce Zion and Grand Canyon North Rim National Parks. To make reservations, please visit our website, canyonrides.com. Canyon Trail Ride family would like to wish the Bryce Valley Mustangs the best of luck.
Clark's Country Market, your hometown grocer, and Rustler's Restaurant is located at 141 North Main in Tropic, Utah. Stop in and try our new menu items at Rustler's. Proud supporters of Bryce Valley Mustangs. Frosty's Cleaning and Sales wants to wish Region 20 success. Frosty's has the most up-to-date equipment and utilizes an enzyme extraction combined with hot water for both carpets and tile. Frosty's also offers custom welding and fabrication. Call Shane or Judy today, 435-648-2178. Garfield Memorial Hospital serves the residents of Paiute and Garfield counties and is dedicated to providing quality, compassionate medical care. Garfield Memorial is ranked in the 97th percentile in patient satisfaction and in the 99th percentile for ER satisfaction. Nationally ranked care in a small community at Garfield Memorial Hospital in Panguitch. Go Region 20. Grand Staircase Inn, your vacation headquarters. 15 miles from Bryce Canyon, we are conveniently located between Bryce and Kodachrome State Park, with the Grand Staircase National Monument Visitor Center just a half a block away. From Carlin and Heather Johnson, go Mustangs! Henryville Town, your gateway to Bryce Canyon, Kodachrome, and Highway 12. Mayor Roberts and the City Council want to wish the Mustangs good luck in the postseason tournament. Go Mustangs! Today, 435-679-8710. Good luck to Region 20 from JCI. From dents to scratches, auto service, paint, and detailing, give Joe a call today for any of your auto body needs. Joe Dalton Auto Body in Circleville, 435-577-2442. Wishing Region 20 team success. There's nothing quite like getting your prescription filled where the employees know you and you know them. We have the time to help you make informed decisions. Personalization that a mail order pharmacy can't provide. At Panguitch Drug, we believe that friendly, fast service is most important. Thanks for supporting Panguitch Drug. Derry Clark is the managing partner of Precise Tax and Accounting located in Cedar City. They are a full-service CPA firm focusing on small business and individual tax preparation and planning. They also offer services in bookkeeping, payroll processing, business consulting, and business structuring. They offer a free consultation.
Red Ledges Inn, located in the heart of Bryce Canyon, is conveniently located on scenic Byway 12, Utah's All-American Highway. Garrett Cottom and the staff want to wish all teams success in the postseason tournaments.
Royal Express Transmission, Stewart and his staff of highly trained technicians can take care of any of your automotive needs, brakes, inspections, alignment, transmission, ATV repair, and towing. Give Royal Express a call, 435-676-8300. From Stewart and RG and Ivy, go Region 20. Mike and Dixie Burbage of Stone Canyon Inn and Stone Hearth Grill offer upscale lodging and dining in the Bryce Canyon area. Enjoy spectacular views while succulent steaks, fish, and chicken sizzle on the grill. Everything made from scratch. Wishing the Mustangs success. Nestled in the valley of the Red Cliffs of Bryce Canyon National Park, a community whose name reflects the beautiful fruit blossoms in the spring, green grass of summer, and the brilliant colors of fall. From Mayor Brinkerhoff and the City Council of Tropic, go Mustangs! Zions Bank in Panguitch, Utah, your full-service bank for all your lending needs. Give Scott Campbell and his professional staff an opportunity to serve you. Wishing all of Region 20 success in the postseason tournaments.
Utah's Bryce Canyon is a landscape so intense, so mind-boggling, that you gotta stand inside it, below it, and above it, just to take it all in. And the only way to be that close to world-famous Bryce Canyon is to stay at historic Ruby's Inn. Now, Ruby's Inn completes your Bryce Canyon experience because it's your home base for family adventure. Give your family that wow moment and reconnect with nature and each other. Plan your Bryce Canyon trip today to historic Ruby's Inn, the wonder of the West.
Something hidden. Go and find it. Something lost behind the ranges, lost and waiting for you. Go. I remember lighting fires. I remember sitting by them. I remember seeing faces, hearing voices while I climb. Very full of dreams, that desert. But my two legs took me through it. Something lost behind the ranges. Now go and take your time.
Becomes their life. College is the next big first. Southern Utah University has the highest graduation rate of any regional university in Utah. At SUU, we know it's not the first day of college that really matters, it's the last.
Having a cabin close to home where you can get away for a day or two or a week at a time is something many people dream of but think it will never happen because owning two homes is a stretch. Gary McKee at Bear Lake Realty has the solution. Quarter shares. You own one-fourth of the property. It's similar to a timeshare, except there are only three others who share time in your property. It's simple, cost-effective, and a wonderful way to have it all. Call Gary McKee at Bear Lake Realty today, 435-946-8888.
Bryce Canyon Half Marathon, 13.1 miles of fast and unforgettable running on scenic Byway 12. From Bryce Canyon City descending to Cannonville through the majestic Bryce Canyon National Park. Race runs on the second Saturday in July. Start training today. Register at BryceCanyonHalfMarathon.com. Come in and see Cocomotive Candy's new location on Main Street in Ridgefield. Browse their selection of mouth-watering handcrafted candy, fudge, caramel apples, and more. They specialize in custom orders for appreciation gifts, gift baskets, or any other special occasion. Call Cocomotive today.
It's that time of year again for high school state tournament basketball. This week, the Sevier Valley Center will host the 1A Boys Basketball State Tournament Games. These games will be live on KTTA 8.1 over-the-air TV and also online at live.ksl.com. Get tuned in and enjoy some great basketball action. It's that time of year again for high school state tournament basketball. This week, the Sevier Valley Center will host the 1A Boys Basketball State Tournament Games. These games will be live on KTTA 8.1 over-the-air TV and also online at live.ksl.com. Get tuned in and enjoy some great basketball action.
Alrighty, folks, welcome back for the second half of the Bryce Valley Mustangs and St. Joe Jayhawks. The Jayhawks lead by two. This is the you're watching Utah High School Sportscast. Mike Olson alongside David Tebbs. It's been a great ball game so far. Back and forth, back and forth. Mustangs in a little foul trouble with Easton and Austin both having three fouls. Defensively, they've done well. Tate gets the ball back, bounce pass underneath to Brinkerhoff, goes out of his hands and out of bounds. But Matt Morton has 15 points in the game, 12 of those coming in that second quarter, Dave.
Yeah, he really spurred him on there.
He averages 19 a game. Morton over Tebbs for two. Down underneath the Dawson Shakespeare puts it up and in. White spins. Out of bounds. Brinkerhoff over Kerrigan, Carrington, White to Ray for three. Morton, rebound put up by Corrington, tipped up in by White. Easton to Trey for three.
And a rebound foul.
That's
on 25,
Don Levy.
Don Levy,
his second. Easton slashes down, rims off. White with the rebound. Morton coming full speed. Doesn't get it. Rebound Tebbs. Leach steps up for three. Got it. One-point game. 36-37, Jayhawks.
What happened on that one, Mike? I missed it.
I didn't see it. I was writing down the three by Tate. Missed the pass. I think it was just a wide pass.
Yep.
Easton. To Tate. Takes a deep three up top. Rims out. Rebound tipped. Easton comes up with it. Dribbles. Taken away by Morton. Morton ahead to Ray.
Oh.
And that's Easton's fourth foul.
Ray just stops on the dime, and Syrek can't change speed fast enough. So he'll sit down at least through the rest of the third quarter, probably.
White drives on Alstrom, pulls up, little floater, won't go, rebound. Carrington kicks it out to Morton. White for three, got it. .40-36 St. Joe. Leach down into Brinkerhoff, goes up past Carrington for two. Two-point game. Morton. Inside, Morton baseline jumper rims over. Brinkerhoff.
Morton.
That's
his
Morton on the reach.
He says he's good, and the coach is like, no, you're not.
Yeah, four
gave him
fouls.
A thumbs up, and the coach is like, no, get down here.
Also, number 31, Gavin Anderson, and he has three fouls for the Jayhawks. Underneath the Brinkerhoff. Tie ball game. Don Levy stripped by Alstrom. Lob in to Anderson. Down inside. Taken away by Alstrom. Out to Leach. And a foul on Don Levy. That's his third.
Good job by Alstrom on that last possession, doubling down, Mike, and getting that ball stripped out of there.
And the Brinkerhoff. Austin spins, hands it back to Tate. Tate drives to Trey for three, won't go. Good look from Trey. He can make that shot.
Yeah.
Don Levy.
Carry the ball.
Carry by Huslin. Ready to Tate, looks. TJ. Rims out, rebound, Alstrom. Austin Brinkerhoff open for three, rims out.
Stays green, no. Didn't go.
Still tie game, 40s. Ray White. Lob backside to Ray. Misses. Brinkerhoff with the rebound.
Boy, that would have been a pretty play.
Brinkerhoff slides around White. Kisses it off the glass for two.
Well, that's one of Brinkerhoff's strengths. They think he's gonna pick up the dribble when he doesn't. Just stays with it.
Offensive foul on Don Levy working against Alstrom. His fourth. So we'll be back after this.
On the weekends, our weeks never end. We give because you need us. You won't have to think about what went wrong. You won't have to worry about how the fix will happen. Because we'll be doing it for you. And that's the way we like it. You may never see us, but you'll be on our minds. We'll be devoted to you all day. And we'll keep working for you all night. We don't come down until the lights are up. And we don't go home until the job is done.
Pass in off that inbounds to Brinkerhoff. Gets it up, and he's fouled on the shot.
Well, thank Garkane. Good sponsor.
Great sponsor. Just got to figure out how to get a little shorter commercial.
Yeah. Can't quite squeeze it in on the full timeout even.
Austin makes his free throw.
But we tried to because of them, we're able to broadcast these games. It's quite a task to do this.
A lot of cost associated, and those sponsors are making it free for you folks at home. Brinkhoff makes them both. Don Levy still in the game with four fouls, Dave. White, defended by Alstrom.
And Leach is getting called with that foul. He's
contact initiated by White.
Impeded his path.
Yeah,
that
maybe
say.
That's what.
Alstrom just a couple more feet. He might have got a 5 second call on that one.
Don Levy misses. Rebound, Brinkerhoff. Leach steps up for three. Rebound, White. Scoops to offensive foul. Tate Leach in the lane, draws the charge. Austin, a little 10-foot floater. 46-40. Offensive foul. Dawson Shakespeare took the charge from Jack Zhang. Easton with four fouls coming back into the game. For the Mustangs, he's got to be
with
very
30 seconds to go in this quarter. Maybe an offensive, defensive substitution.
Tripped up. That'll be the eighth. That'll put Austin at the line shooting 1-1.
So for the whole fourth quarter, Mike, the Mustangs will be at the free throw line. Only two fouls on the Mustangs.
So Trey comes back in for Easton. As well. 48-40, 9 seconds. Don Levy back out to White. Won't go. Rebound Leach.
And no.
So that'll do it for three quarters. 48-40, Mustangs lead by eight. We'll be back after this.
If you want any of these tournament games on high definition Blu-ray DVD, call Rod Syra Video Services. Also, if you have old family videos or old game film that is sitting around deteriorating, give Rod Sire a call. He can transfer your memories to high-definition Blu-ray DVD so you can keep them around for the next generation to see. Call Rod Sire at 435-616-5245.
If you are headed to the state tournaments in Richfield, book your room at the Comfort Inn of Richfield today. Rooms are filling up fast. We offer clean, comfortable rooms with all the amenities to make your home away from home. Enjoy our free hot breakfast featuring eggs, meat, yogurt, fresh fruit, cereal, and more. including your choice of hot waffle flavors. To book your room today, call 435-893-0119 or book online at comfortinn.com/richfield.
Feeling the worst? Snap out of it. Become a new you in no time. With Logomaniacs, look your best. Logomaniacs, the right look for the right price.
All right, folks, hey, welcome back to fourth quarter. It's St. Joe Jayhawk ball. It's been a great game so far. Jayhawks are out to a 4-point lead. Mustangs have battled back. White.
And really, I think the difference is you have Morton and Dunleavy.
Step up, Morton for three. Short, rebound tipped. Picked up by Ray for three. Over the top, rebound White. Won't go, rebound Morton. Chased down by Alstrom.
Interesting who that foul was on. Looked like
Tate Leach is third.
See, it looked like Leach on the rebound had the position. A foul called on Leach.
On the line, Alstrom in Don Levy's grill. Rinkerhoff to Leach. Rinkerhoff drives, triple teamed, up over the top. Travel.
Kind of took a step and then a jump.
Yeah.
Normally he just takes it straight up, but he kind of took a little shuffle, it looked like to me.
White steps up for three over Leach, won't go. Rinkerhoff chases down the rebound. Leach drives, kicks to Tebbs. Tebbs to Brinkerhoff, into the paint. Offensive blocking foul. Wow.
I think even you hear some in the Mustang crowd going, ooh. Looked like White was squared up pretty good.
And that's his fourth.
So,
timeout Mustangs. We'll be back after this.
State Bank of Southern Utah has a variety of mortgage products to choose from, ranging from regular conventional mortgages with loan terms of 30, 20, 15, and 10-year terms to VA loans, FHA, 100% financing with USDA, and jumbo loans. State Bank offers free pre-qualifications, and you can schedule an appointment with one of our experienced loan officers to ask all your questions.
Welcome to the playoffs. We wish you the best of luck at the tournament. At South Central Communications, our dedicated team is working overtime, bringing you the fastest, most reliable network available. I'd like you to meet some of our team.
We lay it down, splice it together, and deliver it to your property.
We connect your home and business and guarantee you'll be running at top speed.
And we're making sure you're completely satisfied with every phase of the game.
SCC's dedicated team won't drop the ball. We're committed to providing with the fastest, most reliable network available. Call us today and get connected, or visit us online at socen.com.
All right, we're back.
We hope you can all come and see,
guys. The right screen.
Brinkerhoff made his first free throw. This is his second. Rebound Morton. Or Don Levy. Sorry. Morton up top. Pass to Anderson down to Don Levy. Scoops it up with his left hand.
Nice little high screen and roll.
Brinkerhoff takes it all the way, scoops it up for two. Morton kicks to Ray Anderson, back out to Ray. Morton. Pass taken away by Tebbs. Leach. Leach wants that shot. Brinkerhoff cuts back door, over the top, misses. Rebound to Anderson. Pass ahead to Ray. Somebody's got to find him. Brinkerhoff does. Morton fakes. White drives over Tibbs. Got it. White is so smooth. Tebbs takes it all the way in. Shakespeare with the put back for two. White into Morton. Morton fakes, steps back for three. That's short. Rebound Tebbs, and Morton's going to foul out on the rebound foul. Clobbered.
Hit the ground pretty hard.
Watch big that replay.
Big rebound for Tebbs. Not so big on the free throw. Missed the first.
53-44. Second one good. Found his range on the first one, Dave.
Yeah.
Second one. We haven't touched anything.
Might be your
testing 1-2. Don Levy to Ray. Anderson, Don Levy. White, defended by Tebbs. Anderson looks. Oh, that's not Anderson, that's Kerrigan. White drives. Scoops it up and scores.
Boy, he's pretty long and quick and just penetrates.
So
really
well.
Really has that first step off the dribble. Hard to stay with him.
Leach will take the three. 57-46 Mustangs into the timeout. We'll be back after this.
Alton Coal Development is located in Alton, Utah. The development employs 32 people at the extraction site and another 30 are employed driving trucks. Alton Coal reclaims the land by restoring habitat for sage grouse and cattle. Alton Coal, restoring habitat and creating jobs.
All right, don't you're in the highlights. We're back, folks. Off the timeout of the Mustangs, it's St. Joe ball, they hand to Ray. He looks at the three. Traveled, no call. Little jumper in the middle by Kerrigan over Altstrom. Kerrigan's first points. Brinkerhoff hands to Leach, fakes, drives. Won't go. Alstrom with the position. White with the rebound. Kicks to Ray for three. Rims over. Rebound Tebbs.
Mustangs thinking there was going to be a foul or something, and out of bounds off the Mustangs. I'm not sure why they didn't call a travel on that last one.
I
they think
don't
they
think
had
they
a hand on the ball? Or?
Well, even if they did, it's either a jump ball or a travel. White rims off. Leach with the rebound. That's good. Good defense by Tebbs. Brinkerhoff loses the dribble, picked up. Ray over the top. Easton with the rebound and then fouled from behind by Ray.
Ray helps him up. You know, these guys are out there battling, but
just working hard.
Still good.
That's only good Ray's second foul.
Put Syrett to the line.
Syrett a little slow getting up. Gets up with a hobble. Makes his free throw, though.
Out Shakespeare in
58-48 Mustangs. White with the ball. Don Levy picks up his dribble. Ray, White defended by Syrett. Syrett has four fouls. Up top, White, defended by Dawson. Anderson. Don Levy.
Boy,
taking their time, looking for that open shot. Mason White gets the lane, loses the handle, out of bounds.
Yeah, it took a lot of time out of possession, down 11. You know, they can put some points up quick, turn on a dime, but.
Anderson to Ray, catches, looks. White, bounce pass inside. Fouled on the shot. Alstrom came over to help backside. The shot was missed, and fouls on Brinkerhoff. That's his fourth. It's a big foul for the Mustangs.
Yeah, it is. Shooting two.
Misses his first. Misses his second. Leach with the rebound. Alstrom.
Good.
I thought he was going to take it. Leach does. Rims out. Alstrom. Oh, the rebound goes down hard.
Wow. You better go down there. Mike's an EMT, so he's going to go down there, too. So I guess I'll try to hold down the fort.
Alston's up. We'll watch that on the replay if I can get it going. Slow it down a little bit. So TJ Brinkerhoff will come in and shoot the free throws for Max Ahlstrom as he has to go out of the game. And Brinkerhoff gets the first one. Let's see if I can keep track of the stats here too. Kevin Talbot, Chris Dennis, Trent Tess. Brinkerhoff gets them both. White brings it up. Anderson. Three by Ray. Missed. And Chris Nez gets the rebound. Failed to mention that. Chris Nez and Josh Brinkerhoff into the game. And Cameron Talbot for the Mustangs. 13-point lead. Chris Nez at the free throw line. Hey, Cherry, how are you? Chris Nez missed his first. Second free throw, gets it. So Nez off the bench with a basket. With a free throw, White brings it across midcourt. Mustangs with a 14-point lead. Pass down low to Anderson. Josh Brinkerhoff called for the foul. Into White, and he's fouled by TJ Brinkerhoff. Enrique Quijada into the game for Tebs. Don Levy almost loses it. White. Down low. To Anderson. He gets the bucket. Josh Brinkerhoff. Enrique. Pass Nez to TJ Brinkerhoff. Brinkerhoff fouled, but no call. Brinkerhoff gets it to Nez. Nez drives baseline. Hits Talbot. Talbot spins, pivots. Can't get it to go. Rebound, Carrington. Dom Levy out to Ray. That's going to do it. The Mustangs are going to advance to the semifinal game, defeating the St. Joseph Jayhawks 50-62. So next game coming up will be between the Panguitch Bobcats and the Merritt Academy Knights. So we'll be back here shortly with the post-game highlights brought to you by Ruby's Inn. Again, this is David Tebs, Mike Ahlstrom. We're outside on the camera with Utah High School Sportscasts on live.ksl.com and on KTTA 8.1. We'll be right back.
Bryce Canyon City is your gateway to Bryce Canyon National Park. We have hotels, restaurants, world-class shopping, parks, and a full range of Western activities. Bryce Canyon City, the place to be. The Bryce Canyon Pines, home to Ethel's world-famous homemade pie, would like to wish all of the Garfield County teams good luck. We would like to thank our loyal local customers for supporting our business for the past 60 years. Bryce Canyon Inn is conveniently located in the heart of Bryce Canyon. Enjoy a complimentary hot breakfast. For dinner, enjoy our world-famous pizza or McLean's favorite, the Sidewinder. The owners, Tyson, Casey, McLean, and Mary Lee, wish the Mustangs success. Danny and Wendy Brinkerhoff of Bryce Country Cabins, located in Tropic, Utah, invite you to come stay in a beautiful, clean, comfortable cabin with a view of the Escalante Mountain that'll take your breath away. Wishing the Mustangs success. Bryce Photo specializes in Old West photos, horse ride photos, and photo enlargement. Bring in your digital photos for Vance and Gene Pollock to print in a variety of sizes. Step back in time and get a photo of how you might have looked in the Old West. Wishing the Mustangs success. Bryce Pioneer Village, comfortable hotel rooms, historic cabins, and for a peaceful outdoor setting, we have an RV park. If you're looking for some great entertainment and dinner in one place, visit the Showdowns Restaurant at Bryce Pioneer Village. Go Mustangs!
Bryce Canyon Subway wants to thank Region 20 teams for eating with us this year. Locals get 20% off regular prices and great deals on catering. During February, all classic footlongs are only $6. We also have full and part-time jobs available. Join a great team and become a sandwich artist. Go Mustangs!
Bullseye Pest Control, specializing in bug, lawn, fruit tree, garden, and weed spraying, termite pre-treats, and free termite inspections. A beautiful lawn doesn't happen by itself. Now's the time to aerate your lawn, serving Garfield, Paiute, Sam Pete, and Wayne counties. Give Jeff a call, 435-313-2855.
Canyon Trail Rides is a family-owned business providing a unique experience on the back of a horse or sure-footed mule. To see the spectacular scenery of Bryce Canyon and Grand Canyon North Rim National Parks. To make reservations, please visit our website, canyonrides.com. The Canyon Trail Ride family would like to wish the Bryce Valley Mustangs the best of luck.
Clark's Country Market, your hometown grocer, and Rustler's Restaurant is located at 141 North Main in Tropic, Utah. Stop in and try our new menu items at Rustler's. Proud supporters of Bryce Valley Mustangs.
Alrighty, folks, you're watching the Ruby's Inn postgame report and highlights brought to you by Ruby's Inn. They're scoring St. Joe, Luke Gray with 7, Matt Mort with 17, Mason White with 18, Danny Donlevy with 2, Gavin Anderson with 4, James Kerrigan with 2, and for the Mustangs, Easton Syrett with 8, Austin Brinkerhoff with 27. He's averaging 29.5 points a game. TJ Brinkerhoff with two, Trey Tebbs with three, Tate Leach with 11, Max Altram with four, Dawson Shakespeare with six, and Chris Nez with a foul shot, 1 point. The Mustangs will play tomorrow night in the semifinal game at 6 p.m. versus the winner of the Merritt Academy Knights and Penguich. We'll be back with that in just a few minutes.
We'll just finish out these highlights.